everybody, it's Sabrina and welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to be doing my March wrap up. So I read so many books in March and I really don't even know how that happened because I was so busy, but I ended up reading a lot of books. I read 12 books this month. Who am I? So without further ado, let's just talk about the books I read and my ratings for all of them because I read some fantastic books this month. So let's get started. So the first book I read was The Memory Thief by Lauren Mansi. I read this for the Owl Crate-a-thon. This book follows a girl who lives in this world that is kind of dystopian style, and in this world you have powers that people have that they can steal memories, and memories kind of flow like currency. So there are people that are in prison that give up their memories in order to make money or make the state money or however they do that. And the main character in the book has the power to steal memories, but the tattoo she has that they're supposed to have to state that they can steal people's memories, she doesn't have. And her mother is in an asylum because she kind of fried her brain. So she actually gets a letter that says your mother is going to be put up for auction. And so she decides to take this trip to another country that is right next to the one she currently lives in, and to try to get her mother not to be put up for auction. Overall, this book was okay. I wasn't mad about it, and I wasn't mad about the story, but I just feel like it was super rushed, and at times it was like, I don't understand what's going on. The magic system, I guess what I would call it, wasn't really explained all that well. So overall, it was kind of confusing at times, but I liked the rest of it. I ended up rating this book a 4 out of 5 stars just because I really loved the story and kind of what they were going for, but I just feel like it didn't really hit its full potential. Next, I read Group by Christy Tate. This book follows a girl. It is a memoir about her time in group therapy. So the reason I wanted to read this book was literally only because I did group therapy and it was fantastic. And it was kind of one of those things that you don't realize how much it will impact your life until you do it. And it was amazing. And I really love learning about her story and how it helped her and how all these people that she did group therapy with are now some of her closest friends and how they've really changed her life. Because I feel like that's what group therapy is. It's just kind of meeting people who are going through the same thing as you and you get to be buds. So I ended up reading this book at 5 out of 5 stars. I absolutely loved it. There was nothing I didn't like about it. This was one of my most anticipated releases of this year, so I just really enjoyed it. The next book I read was Eliza and Her Monsters by Francesca Zabita. I also read this one for Owl Crate-a-thon, but I also didn't read it for Owl Crate-a-thon just because I was already reading it when it started. This book follows a girl named Eliza, and Eliza is the creator of this really big comic that is online, and not everybody knows about it. Only a handful of people kind of know who she is, and she likes to keep this on the down low, and she meets this new guy at school who is obsessed with her comic, so they become really good friends, and it's really, really cute, and it's just kind of her story about how she's found out about and kind of her life is just changing. This book was so cute. I really love, like, there's like all these little like little comics and stuff in it. I'm trying to find a picture. Like, there's a little comic she would draw inside of it, and there's sections where it's just like her texting her friends and like pictures of their profiles on like the fan fiction website they have. If I can find one of those, I literally just seen one 2 seconds ago. Where's it at? Right there. It like shows pictures of their little profiles. It's super cute. Definitely a book that I've never read before, but it was honestly adorable. I loved the characters. I loved the storyline, and I loved all those little details like the drawings and the profiles for the website. It kind of just made it be more real, and I really loved it. I ended up rating this book a 5 out of 5 stars. I loved the storyline. I loved the little details that went into it to make these characters more alive, and it was just really good. Next, I read Conventionally Yours by Annabeth Albert. This book follows two boys who are arch enemies, and they play this game called Odyssey, and when they get a chance to move to go across the country and play in the Odyssey championship game to be like one of the people who go on tour to play this game against people, they both go together and they kind of fall for each other, which was super cute. I really did not expect them to fall in love with each other, but it was definitely the icing on the cake was their relationship that spawned from it, because there was a lot of banter, and I realize with my romance, I like banter. I think that's really cute. So they had a lot of bantering going on throughout this book, but it was so adorable, and I didn't realize that what it was about when I bought it. I just seen gay romance and I love gay romance, but yes, it was super cute and I really liked it. I did end up only rating it a 4 out of 5 though, just because the story at times just kind of dropped off and was like, what is happening? And like would focus on other things that I felt like weren't really necessary. But overall, I did really like it. Next, I read The War Outside by Monica Hesse. This book follows two girls who are in a Japanese internment camp in World War II. If you don't know more about that, Google it because it's super interesting. So they are in there together and one of them is going back to Germany and the other one gets the option to actually go to live at someone's house because she's Japanese until she turns 18 or when the war is over. This book is absolutely fantastic. I'm such a historical fiction person. I love history. It's so interesting to me. And the Japanese internment camps really aren't taught that much. And then you don't hear much about them. Like you hear about the Holocaust and all that stuff. You don't hear about the Holocaust of the States where we locked up these Japanese people. Of course, there wasn't death and all those kinds of things, but we did lock these people up against their will just because of their race. So this is amazing, a book. I really, really think you would like it, but I mean, it's up to you if you read it. I ain't your mama. I ended up reading this book a 5 out of 5 stars. I really enjoyed it. It's definitely not something we normally read about, like especially in an America, we don't really like to talk about the bad things we've done, but we've done quite a bit. But definitely would recommend the read. I rated this a 5 out of 5 stars. I really enjoyed it. The next book I read was The Honey Don't List by Christina Lauren. This book follows an HGTV style couple and their assistants, and it mainly follows their assistants and their love story, which is super cute. It was definitely filled with a lot of drama, a lot of rich people drama, which, okay sis, I love me some rich people drama. And then I was definitely laughing a lot at it. There were so many funny things that were happening and I was like, girl, you wild. That's crazy, I can't deal. But I really enjoyed this book. I'm becoming to love Christina Lauren. I don't think I've read one book that I didn't enjoy by her. So I would definitely recommend this book. It was amazing. And I actually ended up rating it a 4 out of 5 stars just because at times I was like, that's a little too cheesy for even for me, okay? Even for me. The next book I read was Illegal by Bettina Resprero, and I really hope I'm saying your name correctly. If I am not, I apologize. So this book follows a girl who lives in Mexico, and they're very poor, and their father ends up going to America illegally to send back money, and when he stops sending money, they decide to go to America illegally as well to try to find where he is. I loved this book. It was definitely a first point of view of what these immigrants go through and why they choose to come here the way they do. I really enjoyed it. It definitely solidified me for the fact that it should be easier to immigrate here to the US. There's no reason it should be as hard as it is. It was just insane. I love this book and I loved learning about her struggles and the way she had to come here and how her family has, you know, come since, and how the people, even Americans that lived around her, wanted to help her, and I really enjoyed it. I ended up rating this book a 4 out of 5 stars, just because at times it felt really childish to read, and I know it's a middle grade, but at the times I was like, I feel like I'm reading a children's book, but overall I did really enjoy it and I love the story. Next, I read You're Welcome Universe by Whitney Gardner. This book follows a girl who is deaf and she is going to a deaf school, but when she gets expelled for putting graffiti in the gymnasium, she ends up going to a typical school. Now because of this, it kind of rocks her world because she's going to school with people who can hear and kind of don't know ASL and all that stuff. And it kind of, and on top of that, she actually is an arrival with another graffiti artist. So I love this. I love the twist that I had toward the end as well. And also throughout it, it has like different drawings that she's did or like things that she sees around her, because obviously those are really important parts of the story because she is deaf. So she does take in a lot of things visually. So like they have big drawings like she did like this. And I thought that was so interesting. I really enjoyed it. I thought it was so much fun. I ended up rating this book a 5 out of 5 stars. I love books that feature characters with disabilities and like she does. And I really loved listening not only to her struggles, but how she overcomes those struggles and how being deaf doesn't define her, and I really love it. Next, I read The Cousins by Karen M. McManus. This book follows a group of cousins who have never met each other who are summoned to their grandmother's island to work for the summer. Now, I heard a lot about this book. Everybody was raving about it and how amazing they thought it was going to be. I was not impressed, personally. I felt the story was very bland. It had a good premise, and I thought it was going to be a lot more suspenseful than what it was, but really, it was just a very bland thriller. I ended up rating it a 3 out of 5. It was okay. I wasn't mad that I read it, but I also was really disappointed at how the story went, and it just wasn't as interesting as I really wanted it to be. The next book I read was The Cemetery Boys by Aiden Thomas. This book follows a transgender man who decides that he really wants to go against his parents' wishes and turn himself into a bruja, if I'm saying that correctly. So they are a group of people in his community who help ghosts or spirits pass over. I really enjoyed this book, and when he does this, he accidentally summons a ghost of a teenager, and there are a lot of things that go on with that, and I don't want to give much away, so you're gonna have to read it for yourself. But this was amazing. I really enjoyed this book. I really enjoyed reading a book with a trans character because it definitely talked a lot about binding and about his family not really registering that he is a boy instead of a girl now, and it was just, I really enjoyed it because it brought a lot of things like that with questioning his religion and questioning his masculinity, and I really enjoyed this book. I ended up rating it a 5 out of 5 stars. I just loved it. I loved the main character. I loved all the other characters. I loved Julian. He was so Julian. I always forget how they pronounced it, so I'm sorry if I butchered it. Let me know in the comments, please, how you pronounce it, because you all know I'm really bad at pronouncing names. But I really enjoyed this book. I did rate it 5 out of 5 stars. I loved everything about it. The next book I read this month was Binti by Needy Orgreffer. I'm saying that so wrong, and I'm so sorry to this author. But this book is so small. Like, look at this. But this book follows a girl who is the first of her kind to go to this school that is the best in the galaxy. And on her way there, she gets attacked by these creatures, and wild. It's wild. There is no way to describe this book. You have to read it. It's only 89 pages. You can read it in 5 minutes, okay? This book is amazing. It definitely teaches you that who you are and where you come from is part of you, but is it who you are? How leaving home is hard, but especially if it's something you want to do or if it's going to help you be better, then you have to do it. I just loved this book. It was incredible. I rated it a 4.5 out of 5 just because at times I was like, what is happening? What are you talking about? And I had to flip through or Google what was going on because a lot of things weren't really explained, but overall it was great. I loved it. And finally, the very first book I read this month was The Takedown by Corey Wong. So this book follows a girl who is about to be valedictorian for her school. I believe it's like a futuristic book because they have like all this crazy like face recognition and wild stuff. But when a video pops up of her doing dirty things with her teacher, her world kind of starts to crumble. And when she's trying to tell people that's not me in the video, I don't know who that is, like I don't know what happened, she's like kind of really bothered by this. So it's basically the story of her trying to figure out who put this video up and why they did it. Honestly, I feel like this is such a good book because it kind of shows you this is what happens when you decide you're gonna put things on the internet. Because if it's on the internet, it stays there forever, and I stand by that lovely fact. All right, so that is gonna be my March wrap up. I read so many books this month, and I don't even know how. I think it's because I did 2 readathons, and I just read, y'all. Let me tell ya. But that is all the books I read this month. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you comment down below and tell me if you've read any of these books or what you're planning on reading next month in April. If you have not seen my TBR yet, it is linked down below and in this video right here in the card. Click it. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you like it and subscribe to my channel. I upload every Monday and Thursday at 11:45 a.m. Eastern Time. And I'll see you guys in my next one. Goodbye!